A long time coming, but I know a change gon' come. Oh, yes it will. I go to the movies and I go downtown. Somebody keep telling me no. Then I go to my brother and I say, brother, help me please. But he winds up knocking me
been 21 days since little LaMelo, the four-month-old, was killed there in Biloxi in the neutral ground. 21 days, and we still don't know who killed him. He now joins the many African-Americans, he is African-American after all, who have been killed since George Floyd was murdered gangland style and tortured. There's been 181 African-Americans who have, in fact, been killed at the hands of law enforcement, not all of which were killed justifiably. We'll talk about that in a minute. And that is the question now we ask regarding LaMelo. For those of you who seem to think that it's no big deal, you know who you are. I know who you are. And you know what you are. Until you can come up with an equivalent, you can't sit here and tell Rip Daniels that this is just like that. Until you come up with a four-month-old little Caucasian boy that was shot down 34 shots from law enforcement into the car, then you don't have an equivalent. You don't like that. Bigots don't like that. White inferiors don't like that. That's your problem. Don't expect any solace from Rip Daniels. I'm not going to beg you. I'm not going to pander to you like Tim Scott, who's the senator right now. I don't do that. I'm quite articulate, and I have proper subject-verb agreement, and trust me, I don't depend on your evaluation of me. And you know, that's what irritates many individuals, basically white inferiors, who listen to this show. And we don't give a damn what you think. Because you have proven to me what you think. With whatever you have sent to Roa or myself. So, I'll entertain it. Feed you with a long-handled spoon. I don't think I'm falling for it. You know, and sometimes you just got to be blunt like this. Especially some of you Negroes who just kind of feel you've got to pander your life away and get high blood pressure and diabetes because you're wondering about what the man thinks of you. I don't give a damn. I really don't. Roe will tell you. Because people like that don't really give a damn for you. What they're afraid of is you're not worshiping what they say. You know, the worst thing you can do, and the good proof of whether you're dealing with a white inferior or a white bigot, end quotes. Let them know you don't trust them. They will pander to you. Why don't you trust me? Why can't you trust me? I want you to trust me. Really and truly. Man, shut up and let's work. I don't want to hear your dumb jokes. I just work with you. We ain't friends. You don't have to even smile at me. You don't have to even speak to me. You and your Confederate battle flag can stay right where you are, and I don't. It's okay. Don't get in my way. I'm not angry. I'm not sad. I'm not anything, really. I just want to treat you the way you treat me. But let's just get the work done. See, what has hindered my country is exactly that. And some of you who are employers know that. You know that old Chuck over there just has a problem. Every time you turn around, he's got to do some of the old cool joking. Joke's always on somebody else. A bootleg, a Chinese, and a black guy was walking to the blink off. You know what I mean? And then there are those of us who just, hey, what's the matter with you? Do you think that we're getting along by you having... And then they want to come back, well, that's just like this. LaMelo being killed is nothing new. I mean, look what happened I'm sure it happened somewhere, Rip. They just don't go out and cry about it like you. Prove that. 181 African Americans have been killed by law enforcement.
As of April 20th.
As of April 20th, thank you.
Not including LaMelo and his so-called father.
Well, it is. Well, I guess not.
Not quite.
Well, April 20th. So LaMelo was killed in the beginning of May. Thank you very much. 21 days. Okay, I stand corrected. Thank you, Mr. Producer. So it does not include him. I beg your pardon. He's close, though.
So now we can definitively say at least 183 people.
Yeah. Of the 966... 966 police killings reported between May 25th and the May 25th, 2020. The database shows that African Americans account for 18.7% of those who were killed. Despite the fact, of course, that African Americans is 13%, maybe a little lower now. Hadn't seen the census. Police killings of Caucasian victims made up of 37% of the total deaths. Whites, of course, Caucasians. Americans are, according to this, 76% of the population, which I doubt that now. I think they're probably somewhere around 51, 52, maybe. So I think that 76% is off. Mapping police violence data also indicates that of the total police killings since Floyd's death, 11.7% were Hispanic victims, 1% were Native Americans, and another 1% were Asian Pacific Islanders. The race of the victim was unknown is, get this, the race of the victim unknown, you'll never guess. How many victims do you think of police shootings had a race of victim unknown? Just give me a number.
40.
359 people didn't know what race they were. They were ethnically vague. I don't know what I am. Well, I don't know.
Well, then that means those numbers are skewed.
That could be. But it speaks volumes about the fact that you just didn't know who they are. Now, maybe in many cases, law enforcement didn't know what they were, and so he just, killed them and let God sort them out. I mean, that's what they do, you know, sometimes.
Better safe than sorry.
But you have to wonder whether these folks had, if they identified them, whether they had licenses, and what was on the licenses. What's on your license? Is it a W or a C?
That's a good question. Let's find out.
Do they do W's and C's anymore? Or is it AA? Or is it N?
I don't see race on my
Well, you got a face. You got your face. Look at your face. What number is on your, what alphabet is on your forehead?
P.
P?
For peach.
Peach color. Oh, a peach color. But they don't put race on the...
I see class.
See class? You don't see race on your driver's license?
I see race.
Well, you know what that means. You'd be one of these guys.
Yeah.
Race unknown.
Oh, boy.
There goes Roe. Yeah. I can just see it right now. Rip and a race unknown guy in a car wreck. What was he anyway?
I don't know what he was.
Light-skinned.
He had greenish eyes. I don't know what the hell he was, man.
My God. Goatee? I don't know.
Dead. He's dead. I know that.
Other fellow had blonde dreadlocks.
It was amazing.
Where the hell
I'd
he come
never
from?
Seen anything cowboy boots on. I've never seen nothing like that before.
Sort of kind of like one of us, but not. You know, I got those lips.
You got to put them in the vase.
Dead giveaway. Oh, that nose. I'm going to tell you. That had to be somewhere.
Well, I mean, those dreadlocks lock right up there. So.
Well, that's true.
I can't do that with my hair, so, you know.
359 are ethnically vague.
That's amazing.
That's improving.
How, sir?
Well, they're colors. I mean, I just want you to know, this country is moving quicker, closer and closer to being gray, and that's what scared the bejesus out of those who consider themselves pure white.
Oh.
African-Americans accepted a long time ago we were not pure black. Do you know at one time it was a fighting word to call someone black?
Yeah, I heard that.
Black?
Black.
I mean by another African-American.
Yeah.
And the N-word.
Yeah.
It's changed, huh?
What about Negro?
Negro was cool. Negro was in up until Jesse Jackson. Negro was preferred over colored.
And then African American.
See, colored came first, coming out of the Civil War.
Colored.
U.S. colored troops. I mean, when you colored, it was
a big deal.
Oh, yeah. You were colored.
And it was like a gradient scale.
You had to get as far away from nigger as you could because nigger was synonymous. By the way, I'm the only one that can use that word.
Right.
It was synonymous with being enslaved.
Right.
I think I'd explain that. Someone needs to tell Charlemagne and some other individuals, the hip hoppers out there, that every time you use that word, you're calling the person your slave. Hey, my slave. Ha ha, my man. Yeah. Pimp, pimp.
Some of these weirdos might like that.
So, of course, nigger gave way to colored because of the U.S. colored troops.
Mm-hmm.
And then, of course, colored gave way to Negro. Negro. Got to roll that R.
It's black, by the way.
Mm-hmm. And that became very difficult. I mean, the Southern boys with that chow in their mouth, chaw,
yeah,
chew, chow, snuff, whatever it was. You know, that Southern drawl is because of that. You're holding back that spit. Whenever you're holding back the spit, you talk like that. That's why they have a drawl.
Something between your gums and your jaw.
Right, they're holding that stuff in there. You got to hold that in there.
They
cannot pronounce those old sounds. That's why tomato became tomato.
Tomatoes,
you always use that spit gonna come right out. You didn't got a Coke bottle during those days. Mm-hmm. Everyone knows you gotta have a Coke bottle when you chew.
You gotta have Coke bottle plastic.
I'm just saying, that's where look, I'm not poking fun. I'm really telling you where it comes from. That's where the dialect comes from. I'm just telling you. You don't find it anywhere else. Those sounds. Christina? Tomato?
Negra.
No. Just didn't work. I mean, that's a female. 1,127 police killings recorded in 2020. These are actual numbers, not the percentages. Only 16 cases. 16 cases, or about 1.4%, resulted in a charge against the offending officer. We don't know how many of those cases ended up in guilt verdicts or not guilty verdicts. Of the officers identified by mapping police violence, at least 14 had shot or killed someone before. How about that?
Of the cops?
Yeah, of the officers who were identified as killing someone, at least 14 of the 16 had shot some and killed someone in the past.
Makes sense.
Huh. Why does that make sense to you?
I would think that someone who had done it before would have a quicker propensity to do it again.
Hmm.
Killer's gonna kill.
Numbers gathered between 2013 and 2020 indicate African American people are three times more likely to be killed by police than white people, despite being 1.3 times more likely to be unarmed than Caucasian people. In 47 of the 50 largest U.S. cities, police killed black people at higher rates than Caucasians. In Chicago, police killed African-American people at a rate 22 times more than that of Caucasian people, based upon killings per 100,000. Does that alarm you? You do know that African-Americans are far more likely to kill African-Americans in Chicago, so there are those who would say that's justifiable. Let's see the hands. Yeah, I knew it. You couldn't wait to raise your hand, could you? I knew it. See that, Rip? If black folks are killing black folks, why can't we do it? And get a piece of that action, huh? How do you stop another black man from killing another black man? Kill black man. In Miami, racial disparities could not be calculated because every person killed by the city's police department was, in fact, either black or brown. There were no Caucasians killed in Miami. Any Caucasians in Miami? Miami Vice still there? Don Johnson still there?
I think Don's still there, at least. The Crockett's still live there.
Jeez. So there you have it, 181 police killings of African Americans since one George Floyd lay on the ground for over nine minutes being tortured. That's the highest number, let's see, the highest number of killings occurred in Florida, 19 victims, followed by California, where there were 17, and Texas, Georgia. Texas and Georgia followed them, with each having, 13. Of the police killings documented in 2020, traffic stops were listed as the initial police encounter in 121 of the deaths. What is it with that? Wouldn't you have thought that it would have been, like town molestation or something, or kidnapping, or some bank robbery, or murder?
You would think.
On April the 11th, a few miles away, of course, from where Chauvin was tortured and gangland killed by Chauvin and others, Dante Wright, African-American, shot by police doing a routine traffic stop. And that was a my bad moment. Oops. So whatever happened with LaMelo is now the start of a new year. So he will be in the number of deaths 2 years after one George Floyd. Here's my question to you, my audience. So now what? All right, so it's been a year since you've watched this heinous act. So now what? What are you going to do about it? I think Minneapolis, of course, saw its riots and burnings and so forth. And I don't mind telling you. So did Kenosha. Do you know that out of this, what is not counted here, dubiously, are those Caucasians who were killed on behalf of Black Lives Matter? And I resent that. I really do. I think we need to initiate them into the Brotherhood, give them an honorary Afro comb.
Use it too, it just won't.
Well, Rosenbaum can't. He's dead now, and of course, he was bald.
Yeah.
And what was the other one? Huber?
Huber. That was the long haired fellow.
Yeah. These were the guys who were chasing the 17 year old, white and furious militia type. A terrorist of Kenosha, he is henceforth and forever be called. He's now facing trial. This was the one that law enforcement allowed to walk right past them while he, in this quote-unquote riot, was carrying an AR-15. While two individuals lay dead on the ground. This is all you should know. And they need to be included in this. Ladies and gentlemen. Let me tell you why they need to be included in this, because this whole movement was a multiracial, multicultural movement, and that is what scares the bejesus out of white inferiors. The idea that we all get along is the most frightening thing for a person who has to maintain his racial purity or identify himself, and the only thing he can identify himself is the most general thing, and that is his complexion. When that is your prime description, trust me on this, you don't have too much going for yourself. If it's just that little epidermis, that little thin skin right there. And some of you have thinner skin than others. But if that's all you got going for you, trust me on this, I guess you have no other choice but to evaluate each of us based upon that. And then, of course, there's the behavior. You know, I'm really sick and tired of talking about race. I just don't talk about bigots. I find that far more interesting. Because we really don't have a quote-unquote race problem in this country. What we have is a bigot problem. These individuals who sow the seeds of discontent and consistently point out the differences instead of just letting bygones be bygones. You know what I mean? Just live and let live. You white, I'm black, he doesn't know what he is, who gives it? I mean, look, folks, I've traveled all over the world, and I'm going to tell you something. Most people are more concerned with how they're going to keep their cell phones on. You know, whether or not they're going to pay for their light bill. I mean, it's just not preoccupied that way. And there's always Bob sitting there going, why are you hanging out with him? Does it matter to you, Bob? He wears lavender shoes. Okay. Well, does he wear make your feet hurt? No, I'm just saying. I don't know how you can hang around with people with lavender shoes.
I just don't get it.
You know, and what we as a society have stopped doing is we stopped doing one of these. Man, what's wrong with you?
I mean, what do y'all talk about?
Does it really bother you what we talk about? Does it really bother you?
I just can't imagine. Well,
he's got lavender shoes. We talk about everything. We talk about how we're going to pay our light bill.
He ever tried to kiss you?
No, he hasn't. Did you?
No.
Are you concerned that maybe he was?
I don't know. I just don't understand.
I have noticed you don't wash your hands when you come out of the bathroom.
Yeah, no, I don't.
I wish you could see, Ro. I'm going to turn this over there to you. I don't like that look you have on your face. And take off the Billy Bob cap. Where do you get that? What, the MAGA? You got the G and A torn off?
I got it at McHenry.
What happened? He lost now, so you tore off the G and now you got my?
My
mocha.
From my mom now.
He tore off half his MAGA hat. Because Mike Pence now. you just got to laugh at these guys. Listen to me. Representative Green says that having a vaccination is like having a Jewish star.
You know, we can look back in a time in history where people were told to wear a gold star, and they were definitely treated like second-class citizens, so much so that they were put in trains and taken to gas chambers in Nazi Germany. And this is exactly the type of abuse that Nancy Pelosi is talking about.
You believe that?
No.
Some of them do. Look at them.
That
sounds practical.
Really? Really?
Getting a vaccination is like getting a Jewish star. The next thing is the ovens.
Nancy put you on a train, huh?
These folks, man, they're a hero. What do you say to that? I know some of you are working alongside some people who think that. What? How do you deal with that?
Who love her.
You just shake your head and go, him.
Yeah, watch him, though. Gotta watch him.
Did you hear what he did there? So a vaccination is tantamount to having a Jewish star, which means that, okay, you're now in the Jewish ghetto, and therefore all your rights have been stricken, and so the next thing for you is the gas chamber. Just by getting the vaccination?
I'd love to see these vax death camps she's so worried about.
I don't know, folks. I don't know. You realize there are people. All you got to do is become a, what do you call them? Suffer from foxitis? Just a dog network. You watch this over and over again, and I don't doubt you walk over Tucker Carlson. All these folks, man, you say, well, where did they get this kind of logic from, this kind of reasoning? Where did they get this? You know, folks, there are those who are surviving with vaccinations, and they're doing it quite well. However, in Mississippi, I want you to know, ladies and gentlemen, there were some people bragging about the fact that there were no deaths, maybe no deaths, and only we went under 200. Now we have 482 diagnoses, 6 deaths. Most of the diagnoses, Caucasian males. I'm the only broadcaster that's saying that to you, good old boy. You need to be listening to me. Because Dictator Reeves, he wants your vote, but he just assumes you're not still alive because he wants you to act like what real men and not wear a mask and have a vaccination. I'm John Wayne. I'll take that COVID-19 ticket up your rump. You guys, and you fall for this. I don't get it. Here are the numbers. Let's see, did he ever change them? You know, Dictator Reeves has stuck the Caucasian deaths at 17, May 17th. He stuck on May 17th. Let's see here who's leading now in the race for the death. Yes, you're at May 17th, bro.
What are we looking at? Deaths?
Deaths, yeah. You got an update?
I'm making sure.
Surely they've got them. Caucasian males still lead the way, followed by Caucasian females.
Still looking at May 17th.
I don't know why that is. Hey, Dictator, Dobbs, notice I didn't say doctor. This is why you're not a doctor in my book. Because you know better than this. The morbidity report's already out, so now what they want to do is jimmy the numbers to make it look like all's well. As long as we open, with a few good old boys, all they do is dip snuff and have that drawl. And you good old boys go, yep, that's me. I can't wait to go to the deer camp. Just want to make Donald John look good at my expense.
And really, they're not, but based on the numbers of vaccinations, not actually all getting vaccinated, but they are going back out without masks.
You must have some of that sweet chew because your drawl is a whole lot different from Billy Bob.
Well, my wife made me start with the mint pouches, you know.
No matter what, Dictator Reeves, you just can't be too masculine, can you?
Well, really.
I mean, your Adam's apple is covered by your double chin. Are you okay?
I'm fine. Thanks for asking. I just think that, you know, walk softly and carry a big voice is not necessarily what you need to do all the time. Sometimes.
Walk softly and carry a big voice?
Yeah. I just don't.
I saw what your mouth did there.
You see what you saw it?
So, Dictator, what kind of laugh is that, Dictator?
Mine?
Well, yeah, you were the only one. I mean, yeah. So.
This is more of a chuckle.
Why don't you tell your cousin that they need to get vaccinated or at least tested because they're dying?
You know, Rip, I think that, you know, we can't tell people that they have to go get vaccinated. We have to suggest that that's a good idea for them and hope that they make the best decision that they think is right for them.
You know they're going to die whether they get the star or not.
The star?
Well, you know, that's what your affiliate, your fellow Trumplican was saying there in Georgia, that getting a vaccination is like the Jewish people getting a star.
Oh, no, no, no.
No,
no, I'm going to go ahead and distance myself from those comments before I get into more trouble. I don't know exactly if that's what she meant by that, but I don't know.
You didn't distance yourself from Cindy Hingham High Smith going and saying that she would be invited to a lynching she'd go.
Mm-hmm, that's right.
So that's okay. A lynching is different from the Jewish people being taken to the oven?
Well, I mean, I didn't distance myself from it, so.
Well, I guess it is different.
I didn't.
It's one thing if they were lynching all of those several million Jews, but if they're going to take them to the ovens.
I didn't necessarily disagree, and I feel like maybe her comments were taken out of context.
Really? That is always your go-to position? So in what context could Cindy Hingham Highsmith have said, if I was invited to a Sunday lynching, I'd go? So what context would have been there that would have said to you?
Well, first of all, I think we need to be clear on what she said. She said a public hanging. And that could apply to anyone, really. I mean, you know, if enough people don't agree with what Marjorie Taylor Greene said, folks could maybe form a lynch mob and hang her, perhaps. I don't think what she said necessarily was racial in its impetus.
I didn't mention racial. I just meant lynching, period.
Well, I know that, but I mean...
Public hanging.
Yeah, public execution is what she should have
said. Well, she didn't say that, John.
She didn't say that.
No, she said public hanging, didn't she?
She did say that. Yes, she did. Yes, she did.
So that means what? Did you agree, you disagree, or you just...
Excuse me?
You know, I could not imagine you eating a snowball. You have a very hard...
Do you have any?
No, I don't have a snowball. I just know why. But those chicks...
Tiger's blood is my favorite.
What was that?
Tiger's blood.
Tiger's
bit,
blood.
A little bit of cream. Do you have some in here?
No, I don't.
I tell you what, North Gulfport...
Well, give me a hot towel. I want to go wipe off.
Snowball.
Fucking on a slowpoke sucker with those
snowballs.
All right, folks, you can tell what kind of day it's going to be. It is the anniversary of the killing of one George Floyd. And we won't let you forget it. Neither am I going to let you forget the killing of one LaMelo and why that baby died. And who killed that child, to be quite frank. Got a whole lot more, though. Right now, the Trumplicans are preparing for a filibuster to keep us from having a bipartisan commission to investigate what happened on January 6th, whereby Trumplicans, maggots, I call them M-A-G-A-T-S, that's because they wear the maggot hats, and so, you know, you saw them. And, you know, you got a name. Look, I have figured this out. You see, this is what conservatives do all the time. They name it, and then they shame it. You got me? You got to come up with a cool name for these folks. You can't just. So the maggots tried to stop government. Big difference in what was happening. Where was it? The sound off section of your local paper. Nitwit here. I like reading the sound offs. Actually, that's probably the much of what I like about the local paper. This guy says this: enough with Leonard Pitts. Leonard Pitts did a narrative, a column that was talking about the sedition that took place, the actual overthrow of the government, attempted overthrow of the government. Right. So this sound offer said this: compare memories. Enough with the Leonard Pitts narratives. If he wants to compare memories, let's talk about Insurrection Summer. The lives of people ended during those riots. Cities burned. Law enforcement officers were injured. Businesses were looted. January 6th was not the only time our Capitol was attacked. That's just a damn lie. And the God ain't in you. I'm sorry, the truth ain't in you. Or something like that. Kind of repetitive. Yeah, it was the first time our Capitol was attacked, sir. I was around during Insurrection Summer. The Capitol was never under attack. There were no fences. There were no National Guard there. When Martin Luther King was killed, Washington, D.C., Northwest burned. That's right, tucked away behind the Capitol. And many of those places that burned actually were places that were owned, in some cases, well, in most cases, by Caucasians who didn't live there and who were not making any contributions to those local communities. 14th Street, anywhere in that area, outside of Howard, they grabbed the money and then they would go back to their own neighborhoods. Unless only those who contributed were those individuals who were selling CDs on the corner, or those albums. They didn't have CDs then. Had tapes. What I'm saying to you, and there's no reason for looting and or burning, but the reality is that you think people in communities don't know who is ripping off the communities that come in? They provide a service by having a store there, but don't even support the local ball team. You got me? Don't even make any effort to give back to those churches that let out every Sunday, and they go there and buy those Twinkies or mints. A lot of businesses right now in those neighborhoods, and I don't doubt the same was the case in Kenosha and Minneapolis and other places that had burning and looting, even for that matter, Chicago, where you have, you say, why are they burning the businesses? There's no reason why they should, and they shouldn't. But trust me on this, if you lived in those neighborhoods, you will find out their rationale, and here's their rationale. Well, these folks don't, they just take from the neighborhood and then they don't even sponsor anything. They just take it and go, and then they treat us like crap. They follow us around the store, accuse us of stealing. And so you end up with some grudges going on there. Now, again, not a justification. I'm just explaining the mindset of people I have talked to. But New Orleans is another prime example. It's like, well, no, this guy has a long history of doing things and calling the cops on individuals who are just simply outside panhandling, no doubt, but just trying to make a buck. And instead of coming out and saying, hey, look, you need to move it on, blah, blah, blah. And so you end up with bad blood. Again, no justification for why someone would turn on you and do anything to your place of business, or you for that matter. But you can't just take over the years, your daddy was there, his daddy was there, and they all just took, and then all of a sudden, that tinder box is fired up. And the store right in front of where George Floyd was killed and accused of passing a 20, and somehow now goes, well, what, huh? Ironically, the store's still there. Do you know that?
Yeah.
You know why?
Why?
Because of the young man who turned George Floyd in was contrite. He was on the witness stand, ladies and gentlemen, and he lives with the fact that he called law enforcement and it resulted in this. And he begged for forgiveness. What you heard was that kind of contriteness from everybody else who went and testified. For the prosecution, especially. You heard contrite, you heard that kind of forgiveness, that kind of sorry that it happened from everybody else in the courtroom except Derek Chauvin. You know why that is? Because he felt no remorse whatsoever, and that's why he ought to rot in hell, as far as I'm concerned. All right, folks, we're going to go to the phones. Quick break. We'll be back. Herbie, you next.
Start your morning fresh with Wendy's $3 classic breakfast deal. Choose between a classic sausage.